Hiya Meddlers, and welcome to the Forklift Truck Simulator 2009. Oh yeah, now this is going to be fun, I suppose. Yeah, of course it's going to be absolutely fantastic. Now let's have fun with it. Now what are the controls on this? Right, F1 is a driver. Driver's seat mode, so you can look around from the driver's seat and see where you're kind of going. When there's a bar in front, it's a bit hard. Yeah, F2, that's external view. Looking around, that's the driver view again. Oh, you have got a cinematic view as well, so you know, it's like on Grand Theft Auto, the camera angles keep changing externally when you're driving. F4 is automatic view, so if you're going to reverse, the camera will look to the back. Okay, what I'm doing now is moving the mouse wheel forward, that tips the forks forward. And of course, wheeling the wheel back, it tips it backwards. How exciting, you know. And this simulator gets just as good as that, really. It doesn't get any better. Yeah, up and down. Left mouse is up and right mouse is down. That boring dialogue box at the top there is telling me to drive between traffic cones up to the spot marked in green. Use arrow keys to move the truck. Move the mouse to change your view. I'm doing all that. Yeah, F1 to F5 key, changing the views, been through that. You get stuck, you can press the backspace key to return to the start. Now why would you get stuck? Was it because the game crashes on you, or was it because we crash ourselves? Oh, there's a load of boring stuff out here. Oops. Bloody hell, is that dynamite? What the hell was that? It's a bit much. It's just hit a car and you cause a world war. What on earth is going on with that? Oh well, at least it looks good. The Forklift truck's a nice model actually. Except for the wheels going for the arches slightly at the front, but apart from that, it's nice. It's a nice controlled motion till you do that. Yeah, let's start again. Oh dear, I'll get it right in a minute. Yeah, okay. Yeah, let's try and do this properly now. And we failed. And it's blown everything up into smithereens again. How's it going to do it again? Yes, let's have a little party. It's like a thumping party. Like stomp. I can't get to the finish line. Oh, this is so awkward. Oh, yeah. Goal. We're like monkey ball now. Goal. Let's go. Now, let's get the angles right on this. Angles are awful. Don't like them. Oh, let's go whizzing, yeah. So let's have another dance. Oh, it sounds like river dance, actually. Oh, this is stupid. I thought I'd review this game, I know it's old, but I just see it's fun reviewing simulators, really. Being part of a Simulator Sunday, my series I'm doing, so there we go. Oh, dear. Oh, for goodness sake. Slowly work my way through all these simulators. I mean, you've got to try them all. You know, there's so many out there. There's someone can be real gems. I don't know if this one is, but it's, you know, it's all right. It's realistic, actually, to a point. I mean, the actual cart feels a bit heavier than normal, so you're not floating too much. Oh, that's nice. Yes, I win. So what's next? But you've mastered this task. Now drive to the spot marked in green in front of the pallet on the other side. It's not too obvious where that green marker is on the radar there. That just means gobbledygook to me. It's not showing where the... Is that me in the green travelling, or is that... Yeah, it's me in the green. That green marker should be showing up on the... That's it, now they're showing it. Yeah, because there's two markers. There's me, one's me, and the other one was the goal. I don't know. Now it's that red one. Yeah, it's showing it now. At the beginning, you didn't have a clue where you're travelling to, unless you looked at the actual proper vision of where you were going. Isn't that radar was useless at the beginning, but at least we can see on the radar works now. You can see the red dot, so yeah. Anyway, oh, this is awkward. So yeah, I'm pressing the right mouse click to go down, and it should just go. No, it's there. We go. That's a nice view. That's what. See, now you know we have to change the views quite a bit. Right. I don't know what happens when you crash yet. I haven't tried that, but I imagine it won't be anything fun if you do. So you know, we have to see how it works out. Now. I'm just gonna bin this. I'm gonna be a rebel. I don't want to put this in the truck. I think it's a load of rubbish. You know, I'm not gonna do this task. You know, I'm not going to be forced into something I don't want to do. And I wonder why I'm unemployed right now, because I do this kind of thing for fun. And is it going in? I don't know. Oh, there's a load of sand in there. Bloody hell. Someone's been sweeping up. I must be like a cigarette factory round here. That's what they use to put in them. Not joking either. That's what they do, isn't it? Right. That's why I don't smoke. Oh, that's it. That's in lovely. That's a nice job, that is. Where did I get my next one from? Oh, well. Task 2. You know what Task 2 is going to be, don't you? I wish I could write the scripts to this gun. I really do. Anyway, Task 2 is going to be lifting the truck. Let's see if you can. Should be powerful enough. Or you might need two forklifts to lift this. But in reality, it's failing. And in reality, that would snap probably by now. And so that would just catapult and hit me in the face. That's why I've got a cage on the forklift. Come on, I thought it'd say, oh, you know, game over. You know, you're not allowed to do that. You got suspended. But no, it's not, is it? It's going to say nothing. Come on, I want to lift this up. Something's got to happen here. You know, I want it to like be flung. Sometimes the physics go wrong in these games and things get flung miles away. So I wonder if that's going to happen. That'd be so funny if that just launches up into space. Oh dear, I've buggered it now. What the hell is going on with that? He can't even move now. That is just totally screwed up. I can't reverse. Oh, I can, but not much. That's it. That's as much as it'll let me go. Come on, break off. I want to do this task properly now. What's it latched onto anyway? I mean, for goodness sake, it makes me laugh. It lets you pass through it and then it won't let you come back out. Must be some point to that somewhere that it's getting stuck on. Oh my god, it's doing the jive. Look at that. Look at those bars jiggling about. It's like you're on jelly now. Oh, well, that view doesn't work, obviously. Yeah, I'll screw this up, I think. Oh dear, screw up time. That is totally screwed up. Yes, I think I'm going to abort. That ain't going to work, is it? It won't let me do anything. It's not fun. Right, okay, let's attempt this one last time. I want to complete the tutorial properly now. Yeah, I'm going to be a Mr. Boring Pants now, Fart Pants. Right, I'm going to do this, the Mr. Jobsworth. This is Mr. Jobsworth coming through. Got to make sure everything's done completely nice. And that ain't one of them. Okay, that is nasty. Why do they do that? You know you've crashed into them, so why make a point of bashing them about? Now, you know, it'd be nice if this whole row was coloured in blue, so you could sort of, like ice, you could see where it was. Or have different weather elements in this would be nice. I haven't seen any as yet. Have ice and snow, you know, you slip about, or rain even would be nice. You know, shiny effects, but I know it's a 2009 game, but they had those effects in those days, didn't they? So, in those days. Not that long ago, 4 years ago. Oh dear, that's not good. Oh, for goodness sake, come on. Yeah, I was hoping just to whiz this bit through quickly because I want to get onto the main gameplay. But I've got to do this. Oh, see, what's with that? Every time I knocked a cone, the whole lot jumps, but that one went flying. It was alright. Oh well. I like that. Unfortunately, you ran into an object. So telling me to drive slowly and keep the arrow key pressed to for a steeper steering angle. All the science in that. Oh, I envy people who write this stuff. Not really. Oh dear, we're going to get there in a minute. Yes, and voila! Brilliant! It's now mission complete. Objective is ahead of you. None of that. None of that at all. Just expects you to just follow the dialogue. There's no voiceover, because I didn't want to pay a tramp to do any voiceovers. You know, they could have got some student in on this game to do a voiceover or something. Do it in different languages as well, it'd be nice. But no, they won't do that, will they? The only thing I like about the game is the model of this. I mean, I don't like forklift trucks anyway, but it looks nice anyway. Yes, okay. Typical, I'm trying to do it properly and I can't pick it up quickly now. When I was mucking about, I was doing it better. Because there's less stress, I suppose, with this. Because it stresses you out in a way. Now drive the pallet to the spot marked in green on the lorry. Yeah, there it is. Destination, come in. And the red one means, yeah, you've got to bunk it on there, haven't you? Bunk it or dump it, whatever the word is. It drives you insane, this stuff. That's why your brain goes to mush, basically. Yes, another mission complete. Oh, look at my driver's license. Oh, I've lost my face. I must have hit myself with the forklift truck at some point. Never mind. At least I'm qualified to drive now. So what do? Just hook this up to my printer and take it to the nearest warehouse, do I? So I'm sort of ready for work. As I'm a qualified forklift truck driver, I can now play the game properly. Oh, this mission's alright. So you've got to unload 8 pallets from the back of a lorry in half an hour. That's not going to take half an hour. It's going to take 4 hours on this. Where am I going? Got a green marker, got to get my bearings on this. Bloody hell. Not to crash into anything as well. Right, so I'm the green marker, right. Where's the truck? Which depot is he in? Oh, there he is. Whey! He's turned up. What happens if they don't turn up? They could be late and stuck in traffic. What do you do then? Oh, go, fun and joy. Line up the claws. And it's not lining up, that's it. Whey! It's all... Mission 1, complete. Or stage 1. Don't smack into the... Oh, don't do that. And... am I going the right way? Who cares? I don't think I am going the right way. No, I'm not going the right way here. Yeah, that's the dead end. I was hoping I can get around that bar. Why do I always go the wrong way? Yeah, I hate warehouses anyway. You can never find what you're looking for because some idiot puts it in the wrong place. Always found it working in a warehouse. Someone's too like busy or too, you know, done things too quickly to be bothered to put things back properly, so they just dump them anywhere. And then they wonder why they can't find it and they ask you where it went. And they blame you for moving it. It's always a why. Right. Okay, so that's green now, so it should be alright. And I let go of it, that's good. I thought I was going to get stuck on it then. This is fun. It'd be nice if they stuck a character in the chair so that it looked like he was having fun. Instead it looks like a ghost driving it. So I'm certainly not driving it, or not well anyway. It makes me laugh, the steering wheel on that thing reminds me of the little kiddie cars used to drive around the theme parks. A steel handle on and all that, I remember that. They're probably more efficient than this thing anyway. Oh, don't crash into the box, it's too hard, so it'd probably be a fail then, wouldn't it? Yeah, I prefer driving looking outside the box. See, I'm always looking outside the thinking outside the box. And that is the case we proved then. Right, now, where to the next one? Ah, right, the far side. That's not too bad. It would be if I was going the bloody wrong way again. I'm going the wrong way. Ah. That's not too taxing, this, really. I mean, it'd probably be more taxing if you had the steering wheel and the proper controls. Like a replica, like dashboard of this thing. Then it might be harder to play if you had all the real levers, but when you're just using the mouse and the arrow keys, it's not really difficult. I can see this game getting old quite quickly, actually. You got to mess it, get this to mess about with, that's what I'll say. Have a few upturns with it, or try and crash or something, you know. Do all the missions. You can complete this game probably in about an hour. All the other missions on it. But there's only like another mission or two after this one, and then there's just the free roam game. You've very limited, but you'll see that soon on this review. Even though I'm taking the mick out of the game, you've got to try it to its full capability, because otherwise you don't know what you're getting out of it. You don't know what it, you know, it can do, could you? So you've got to, you know, do things. And this truck though is weird. Ugh, bloody thing. Line up. There's only two holes here, for goodness sake. Oh shit, that was close. Reversing. I'm probably going to come unstuck reversing out of this. Hitting the truck or something. Yes, I'm getting the hang of this now. You think I'd have my license for years now, the way I'm operating this. It's like I'm professional. Yes. It's got to be easier in real life driving one of these things than it is on the game. Oh yes, the man has got skills. Look at this, it's going straight in there without a fuss. Without a fuss, I said. Come on. That'll do. It's green. Oh, it's red. Let's bugger that up. Come on, don't be so picky. What if I leave it on the floor? No one's going to know. Check up on me, are they? Is it going? Is it in? Yeah, that'll do. It's straight, not straight, but... If someone's fussy, then they've got a problem. Not me. Don't give me much space, do they? I thought it would be another few racks larger, this alley, this lane here. I mean, why do they need to be so spaced out? I mean, so close together. I mean, yeah, I know the real warehouse, they want the space and everything, but this is only a game, so they could... Oh, bugger. What can I say about that? Screwed me right over, didn't it? Oh. Right, let's try this again, come on. Let's do this properly. This time, if I crash, I'm not going to do another one. Right. Alright, let's get in. I like the one wheel on the back. I don't know why it's one wheel. Why did I decide on that? Movability, you know, like you can move on a coin. Spin of a coin, I don't know. Okay. Just thinking, I just had a mind freeze then. I wonder what's going on. Oh, let's fill up again. So I've got to basically do two trailers in there. I can count at least. So I've got to drop off eight things altogether and put them in the truck. Nah, I should get that done alright. Well, providing there's no wall in the way. I mean, if that happened in real, you're doing this in the real life, you crashed into something, surely you just carry on with your shift. If your truck still works, then what's the problem? I mean, yeah, you probably have to load the paperwork to fill out, insurance and stuff, but... You know, that could wait later, or you can just ignore it and just let someone else pick up the blame. Oh, here we go, that's it, nicely. Yeah, look at me, I'm doing that nicely now. It's like a challenge, it's like You Bet This, a challenge show used to be on Saturday night or Friday night. With Matthew Kelly. You get someone frantically, oh, that's buggered that up. Trying to, you know, do the task, you know, this would be a good one to do. Really would. Now is it going to pick up? Oh yeah, now it does, good. I thought if you tip it up, it would never pick up again, you know. Ooh, thought it'd be like a slight glitch in the game, but no, it's alright. Well, I mean, I'm quite impressed. There hasn't been any glitches as of yet. I mean, obviously stupid stuff like getting stuck in the side of a lorry earlier, but that's because they didn't really expect you to try and pick the lorry up with a forklift, so I can forgive them for that one. So, there we go. Way. Now I'm gone. Yes. It's like sliding in and out like a knife and butter now. If I can keep this up, it should be over pretty quickly, this level, because it does get a bit repetitive, this game, I must admit, because, you know, there's no like kicking footballs around with a forklift truck, like they do on Top Gear. They're using cars to play football with. That'd be better doing that than doing boxes here. I mean, it'd be better if these crates are more interesting, you know? Had iPads on there or something, or... I don't know. Even bricks on there look better than a cardboard box, to be honest. Or sugar, have sugar on there. The bag splits open. You know, add a bit of danger into the game. Or cooking oil. Oh, cooking oil leaked everywhere. And it's like a slippery road you've got to drive on then. You know, so you've got like, your reaction times have got to change. Because at the moment the game mechanics stay the same, and once you learnt it in 5 minutes, you're set for, I won't say for life, because you probably only play this once in your life for 30 minutes, if that. So you're probably set for 30 minutes of your life. Oh dear, if they're renting this game, I probably wouldn't even rent it. But yeah, as you know, sort of regret paying for this, but. I got it cheap anyway, you know. Got it cheap second hand, so that's the main thing. Game's a pittance now, as it's 2009. Get it in the old bargain bins, that's what I say. Pick them up. They're good for a few quid. Can't complain. I wonder how much this was originally. It's probably like 30 quid or something. You know. I was typing in this on the internet, having a look at reviews for this game. And it was saying, like, oh, you can get like a forklift truck from £3,000. I thought, oh, that sounds bloody marvellous. That I wouldn't get a car, I'd just get one of those trucks. That'd be interesting, that would. Imagine picking up your shopping. You could raise the forklift bar up, hang your carrier bags up from it. That'd be brilliant. You could do all sorts of it. or if someone smashes into you, you can just like flip them off yourself and with the fork. That'd be, you know, best way of doing things. I don't know what else you could use your truck for, really. You could put some, like, leave a pallet on there, and then you could just hire it up and sit on it and hire yourself up, and you could, like, sit down and watch, like, parades or, you know, things happening in the public place you want to look at. Watch the air show or do something. Go to the beach with it. Yeah, I mean, you don't actually see anyone driving them around publicly, but it'd be funny if you do. I don't think I've got that right. I'll pull it out anyway. Now, will I be able to get this onto two forks now? It's going to be a bit of a problem, this, because I've got... Yeah, I don't want to smash into anything going backwards, do I? So, one good thing about playing this, though, it is therapeutic, though. So, that's, you know, stress levels have gone down a bit, actually, because it's repetitiveness, though. It's all human nature. We've got to have routine. So, I suppose doing the same thing here... It's sort of, your brain goes a bit cold one side, but the other side goes warm, if you know what I mean. You're sort of annoyed because you're getting bored, but you're sort of getting relaxed because you're doing the same thing. So, maybe it feels like you've got a job to do when you really haven't got one. And, they're testing me out here, look at this. Top shelf, bit of smut. Here we go. Oh, it's a shame. It'd be good if you could break through that window, the fork. Now, this should be easy. And we're down. And I'm out. That'd be pretty disastrous if you dropped that off the top, because, you know, it's a long fall, that is, and you just probably go upside down. You won't be able to pick it up. There's many experiments to be done on this, like, you know. So if it actually fell upside down, that pallet, could you pick it up again, I wonder? Would it let you, or did stuff fall off it? Keep hearing like car doors or something, or is that just me? It's probably me clipping stuff with this forklift truck, isn't it? I didn't get it again. Maybe my forks aren't set right, I'm not really paying attention on that score, to be honest. I just want to get the bloody thing picked up. Oh yes, look at this, I need to speed up now. There must be a cheating way of picking two up at the same time, surely. I've seen them do it, I'm sure it's against regulations or whatever, health and safety. I've seen them pick up like a stack of two or three pallets loaded before on one of these things. But it was rocking about the forklift truck, like the back wheels were coming up, back wheel whatever, it just coming off the ground. I'm sure they're not allowed to do that, but they do. And I suppose there's a law like about how you're driving with the forks, has it got to be down or up, does it matter? I suppose there's some sort of law of that as well. It's a danger, I suppose. Imagine being impaled on one of these things. Wouldn't be a laugh, would it? Oh, come on, the journey is so slow. Someone's probably made a mod for this, if they could be bothered to speed it up. That'd be good. Doing 60 miles per hour in this thing, yeah, that'd just kill yourself and kill the game. Physics would go a mess then, if you hit a wall. Everything would just go flying. I need to hit the wall then as well. God, there's got to be some action happening in this in a minute. Maybe a penguin coming out or someone shooting at me because I've done the job wrong. That could be a possibility. I mean, this area looks rough actually, so anything could happen. Oh God, tight one, this one. Just drop this one in and plop it in. There you go. No, that's not set. Oh. Drop it. I'm not going to be OCD over that. You know, that's straight enough. You stored it, that's the main thing. It's not level, but there you go. Now, okay. So a new truck to... Oh, there's always one more, isn't there? So annoying. There's always one more. Just when you think you've had enough, they throw another 10 at you. Oh, I've got to trust how I've completed this anyway. Even if it's one mission today. Oh, I nearly hit that wall. And that would have been game over again. And that would be so annoying. Oh, God. The steering on this is weird. I mean, why would you have a tiny handle like that? On the steering wheel. At least it looks like it's rubber, so you can't smack your head on it. Or you wouldn't cause any damage. I suppose that's why it's like that. I don't know. The only thing I do like about this is it's well lit in here, so you can see what you're doing. So that drives me mad. Could be another challenge if they turned all their lights off. Play in the dark. Let's put strobe lights on the shelves or something instead. You know, then at night it could turn into a rave party or yeah, a garage scene or something. Oh, you're having a laugh. I'm just going to whack that straight on. I'm not going to bother. Whoops. That'll do. And he's on. Yes, next one. Woohoo, 10 minutes and 6 seconds. Is that a record? It must be, because it's the first time I completed it. Never mind. Where's that? Glad that didn't go on for too long, that one. Now for the next mission, you've got a rush order. You have to pick 8 pallets. Oh, okay. From the racks and load them onto the lorries. That's not too bad then. What's actually the same the other way around? Oh, that's interesting. But there's not a lot you can do with storage though, is there? Can't make it fun even if you tried, really. You just stack them and slap them. And they all topple down. I suppose you could play Jenga with one of these machines, like on your break time. And, yep, I've got the wrong way again. Why do I always face you the wrong way to start with, anyway? It drives me mad. It's insane. It plays with your head. Right, where are we off to next? Oh, I see on the radar. Of course it's a radar. What else would it be? You should put a radio on this thing or something. We'll have live streaming internet music so you can listen to while you're driving it. God, this concrete floor is getting on my nerves. It's all the same. Leading all the way down. And our destination. Great. Now we can pick it up and go on. Come on, get up. Yes, it's coming. And we forked it one. And it's stuck already. And it's going to get crashing into the barrier again and it's going to end the game. Oh, it sorted itself out. That's unfortunate. I wanted to see something funny happen then. Yeah, you can't break anything in here because you get a warning dialogue box and then it ends. So there's no fun to be over crashing. Or trying to break the game, in fact, really. Oh, look, at least we can load these in the truck, no troubles. Or hopefully there won't be any troubles I run into. Apart from the old wall. Hey! First one down. Another 7 to go. Whatever it was. What, how many it said, I can't remember now. You've got to let go. Oh, it's got to tilt the fork, I think. That's what it's just, you know, it's attached itself onto me. Oh, come on. Just give it a bit of a wiggle. Wiggle it off. Oh, I've got loads to do here. Come on, stop wasting my time. Oh, for goodness sake, why is that the only crate that's ever done that? Come on, I must have had a rough bottom to that. Way out and about, swinging all about. Come on, move on. Move on to the next one. Objective. Yeah. Oh, this reminds me of playing Fable. So I've got 2 or 3 or both of them. We just like chop wood. I like to build your money up or your skill level up. You just keep chopping wood. And I was doing it for like probably 2 hours once. Just chopping wood just to get my level up, and that was just a waste of time looking back at that now, and it's the same as this really. Just like chopping wood. Do the same action all the time. I mean, you don't like benefit from it, but just your on-screen character does, which is stupid. There you go. Move this on, and we're away. I wonder where this goes now. Oh yeah, of course, I forgot it's a lorry, isn't it? Of course, you can put it anywhere else. Well, you could, but you just run out of time. I mean, this hasn't toppled over yet. That'd be funny if that went. Well, I suppose it would be funny. Oh, dear, the action. Oh, yes. Come on. Move, you bugger. They should make this multiplayer. That'd be something to look at, worth looking into. Could have, like, you know, challenges. You've got to try and get... Yeah, the one that can do the most work, but you can't crash into each other or crash into anything. It would just be like Robot Wars though if you did that, I suppose. No work would get done. That, see, that crate just dropped straight away. It didn't even attach itself onto me at the end like the other one. It's a bit weird, the behaviours on some of these. Right. I'm doing okay. Oh, it's all good from here now. Yeah, I've got the hang of this big time. Yes, I'm going to beat this game as well now. Right, it's always, why is it another top one? I'm obsessed all of a sudden with this. It's constantly top ones I have to grab. Oh god, the grounds out there look bad. Anyway, concentrate, I was going to lose this. And I nearly did, bloody hell. I don't know if you're able to get these back if they go too far down the back. And that's nicely on. Way. Nicely played. And it's fantastic. That's brilliant. Can move on. Yeah, okay, that'll do. I prefer driving from outside. I don't know what the reason is for it. Just, I like to see the angles better from all around. Sometimes it's hard when you're lining the forks up. You can't really see without the driver's view, but I can't be bothered to move it. Keep pressing the F keys all the time. I really hate that. Is this going to go down, or is this going to play silly biggers? Is it going to go down? Come on, go down. You stay, and it has. Yes. Now that is what I call progress. Now that is something good that's coming out of this. Is I can be more efficient with the keyboard. You know, using the control pad a lot on the old consoles, it's a bit different, so I'm used to that, not this control method. It's funny, it's a lot of games I'm better on the control pad on the consoles than I am on the keyboard and the PC. But when it comes to certain games, like when I was playing Grand Theft Auto, for some reason when I was doing like shooting on that, I preferred to use the keyboard and mouse. So a pad is generally sort of game where it sort of differed. It's kind of weird. Oh, they're brilliant, I'm not concentrating. Oh well, that's that level ended. I'm not doing that one again, that's for sure. Alright, what have we got left? Warehouse optimization. Okay, now what do we do here? Okay, rush order. So it said I've got to get 8 pallets from the racks and put them into the truck. Sounds like the same one as before, really, but apparently in a rush. Oh, fantastic. This is going to be mind-blowing, isn't it? Now, I've got to muck about on this before this review ends to see what it can really do, this truck. It's not putting it to its paces yet. It's just, you know, doing what it has to do. It's really weird. That's on the back of this forklift. It looks like an Allen key holding the wheel in place. Could be wrong. Doesn't look very secure anyway. That's the main thing about it. Oh dear. Hope my shift should be ending soon. Have my lunch and all that. Oh dear, come on. That'll do. Move forward. Now, move forward. That'll be fine. Maybe, see, I've gone too high. Oh, I should listen to myself more. It's all pokey pokey. And it's fruity fruity. There you go. It's in. Now let's see if I can be bothered to do this properly without crashing into anything. Now that's a true test. As if you can actually drive straight when you're trying to concentrate and be serious, but you're not really about this one. Yeah, I've kind of lost the way now as well, as you know. It's just it gets like that. And we're around again. Oh, isn't that nice? And we're there. What else can be said about this, really? If you've got the idea. Oh no, the next one's due next to that, so it will drive all the way back there again. You can really gather what you have to do in the game mechanics, so you know, that's what I need to show you, really. So, right. Yeah, free play, this looks more of a laugh. No time limit, there were 2 scenarios. Yeah, let's do the freight train. Should be some action in this, hopefully. And well, there might not be. I'm going to make some action, that's what I'm going to do. Sod the rules. Let's just go for it. First thing I want to do is find the exit to this place. There's a freight train involved. Well, it's not here, is it? Hopefully I can get access to the train. That's what we need. Yeah, come on. Why is it so birdy all of a sudden? Didn't hear birds earlier. I had all the doors open earlier as well. Cool. Oh, I skipped to the right. I just saw. Yeah, there it is. Yeah, well, good old skip what I dumped stuff in earlier. It's pretty emptied it now. It's pretty all been dumped. God, this goes bloody slow, doesn't it? Alright, can you jump down there? No, I won't, but. Oh.
No, that's close enough. I mean, the wheel's already sinking through the tarmac, so I won't go any further. It'll probably just be a crack. Oh, look at that. Just caught that in time. That's nice. Oh, not close up it isn't. It's a bit blurry, but... Yeah. Let's see if I can get inside this. Was it going to crash? No, it does. It lets you go on. Now, I would sit here and wait for this to go off, but I don't think it ever will, this train. I think we'll just sit here, so I'll be wasting my time. See what else you can do on this then. Where else we can explore.
I'm looking at this, probably not much to explore. Train, I was hoping to take off again now, come on. Or take off at all. It caught me like going off in it, it'd probably leave me behind though. Probably just go straight for the wall of it and that's it. Oh, died anyway. Oh, that's fantastic. Okay, let's get out to more mischief, if we can. Just trying to don't let you crash or anything, that's really out of order. You just, you know, bang, a dialogue comes up. Bang, this dialogue comes up. I mean, the only bang you see is that the cones are bouncing in the tutorial. You know, they go off like explosions, but why don't they let anything else do that? It'd be so respected, this game, if it had some more effects in on that. You know, you bend your fork on your fork if that happens, you know. It might tip over, and why's that door opening on that train again? It just turned up, it's got a loop, it just disappears and just comes in again. Must do, I say to myself. Oh, look, there's a rocket launch over there, look. Whee! A rocket there, to the left. Hey! It must be a NASA area. Oh, graffiti. I wonder if they actually pay kids to graffiti that train on the Paint Shop Pro. Or do they get like a 40, 50 year old programmer to do it? Who knows? That'd be interesting to see who does the art. Really would. You know? It's I'm just going to cause carnage with this. I'm going to see if I can drop this in the track. That'd be good. Task is on. Will it happen? Will it let me? Okay, go in. Oh, I've got to shove it in. Can't drop it in. That's it. Drop it and lift the fork up and then I'm going to knock it straight onto the track. Wish me luck. And we're... You spoil. Oh, anyway, thanks for watching, meddlers, and I'll see you later. Am I still recording? Bye.